Hey guys, AJ Hazzi here for the last video update of 2014. Welcome back to the video blog. We are going to continue with the question and answer. I know that you guys would all get a ton of value out of some of these tremendous questions that our clients have been sending in. So without further ado, I'm just gonna get right into the questions. So question number one from Lee, she wants to know, what is one of Kelowna's or the Okanagan's most up and coming neighborhoods for 2015 for investment? And that's a great question. In fact, the answer is in an article I just read in this magazine that I subscribe to called the Canadian Real Estate Wealth Magazine. And what they've said is that downtown West Bank is poised to be the number one investment for our region. And there's a reason for that. There's a revitalization plan that's planned for downtown West Bank that is going to completely change how that area is perceived and of course the value of those properties. So anything in and around that downtown core, whether it takes a year or 5 years for that plan to be executed, represents great value and a really good long-term hold. So great question, Lee. Next question, local mortgage broker, Mike Huber. He wants to know, why do more clients not take advantage of the home renovation plan? And this is a really good question. In fact, I believe this plan can help a lot of people. What it is if you've got 10% down to put on a home that you're moving into, you can also apply to have the bank put in an additional 10% for uses such as new kitchens, bathrooms, finishing a basement, anything that adds value. So all you need to have is your own 10% of the property's value, and then the bank will actually finance your renovations, which can go on to add tons of value to the property for yourself. So I think it's a great way if you're putting together all of your money for your down payment, but maybe you're a little bit short on capital to do the renovation. The home renovation plan, which you can get through a great mortgage broker, is a great way to go. So good question there. And lastly, a question from Andrew. He wants to know whether when I'm doing a property flip for myself, whether I hire out the renovations or whether I do them myself. Well, not just because I'm completely useless with a hammer, I always believe you should hire it out for a couple of reasons. One, you don't really end up saving any money because when the job that is done is not a 10 out of 10, it'll cost you money in the long run when you go to sell the property. And secondly, time is money. And I've seen time and time again, clients do things themselves and it takes them 3 or 4 months to do what a professional contractor might be able to do in 2 or 3 weeks. And when you add up carrying costs and you add up the aggravation costs, it doesn't save you money. And the last piece, which I always think people forget, is while they're working at the project themselves, they're not out working at whatever it is that they do. And renovators don't cost any more than you probably make at your own job, so it becomes a wash. So I think always hire a professional. I use a gentleman by the name of Alden from Sweet Rental Solutions. He's been phenomenal. And if you want to give me a call, I'd be happy to pass along his number. So there you have it. 3 great questions. Hope you guys got a ton of value. We're going to keep rolling with the Q&A. If you have questions you want to hear answered, please, by all means, send them to us by email. And of course, don't hesitate to reach out with any questions. We're always here, even on Christmas. You can give us a call, 250-717-3133, or reach out to us online. Thanks so much. We look forward to chatting with you in the new year. Bye for now.